to the research challenge in Thailand, semi-final round. In this round, you are going to present, give a presentation for 10 minutes and Q&A session for another 10 minutes. When there is 1 minute remaining, you will see the sign here said 1 minute left. And start to say the time when the time is up. All presentation and Q&A must be stopped. When, before we start, let me introduce our judges today. From my left to my right, first, Khun Khun Thak, Institutional Research at KTB Securities. Second, Khun Bia Thida, she is Senior Equity Research from NTSF. Third, Khun Adaporn, former Head of Research, UOB Security. And fourth, Khun Kim Pai, Equity Research from UOB Securities. Now you can start when you are ready. When the timer will start when you first talk.
Good morning, the panel of judges. We are Team 15, and we are here to present our recommendation and analysis on Bangkok District Medical Service, BDMS, one of the largest healthcare service providers in the Asia Pacific. We would like to present a buy recommendation at the target price of 28 baht. With 18.64% upside. The potential upside comes from three main growth pillars: strong competitive positioning, supportive future trend, and robust financial performance. And we would like to elaborate this point into more details.
For your strong competitive positioning, BDMS has acquired 46 hospitals in Thailand and Cambodia. In this region, BDMS developed the Center of Excellence as a hub of hospital and refer the patient of the school hospital to acquire, to have the service that have the advancement. BDMS, you have the business that expand to the preventive care, curative care, and rehabilitative care. For the group of the number of the hospital, BDMS have the Bangkok Hospital, Smithfield Hospital, BNH, Priyathai, and Pavlo. With all these hospitals, can acquire cover more of the patient purchasing power. In this strategy, can drive the market share of the BDMS from 2013 48% to the 55% in 2017. For the EBITDA margin, BDMS have the highest of the 24.39% when compared to the large number of the network in international hospital peers still being in the pioneering position.
Supportive future trend support our recommendation. By the year 2040, we will enter hyper-aging society. With more than a quarter of Thai population will be over the age of 65 years old. Next, we have increasing illness from critical disease. From 2002 to 2018, the CAGR from the increasing illness has increased 8.44%. And next we have increase in tourism trend. The CAGR has increased 11% from 2008 to 2019. For the internal factor, we have organic growth through company. With the increase in patient revenue from insurance income, we can see that the trend starting from 2011 from the quarter of 2018, the CAGR has increased 21.58%. Where we support with the document from the insurance industry with the increase in health insurance, with the increase in health insurance and personal accident insurance, we sum up with the total of CAGR at 14.59%. According to support the increase in insurance revenue, we can see that the utilization rate has increased from 2017 to 2024, has increased to 71%. With the debt composition, we have a positive gain from the sale of Buckham Head Hospital at 5,089 million baht, driving our PE ratio down from 2024, where you can see that BDMS has the lowest DE ratio among its peers.
In addition to the risk profile, the company has shown a robust financial performance. Historical revenue and earnings per share of the company has been both annually since 2013. This led up to the increased free cash flow of the firm in our forecast. For our evaluation, we use the nature of discounted cash flow and price to earnings multiple at 20%, 80% less effectively. This gave us the target price of 28 baht with 18.64% upside. For discounted cash flow, this year approach, we use capital asset pricing model to determine our cost of equity. The cost of equity is 8.32%, while the cost of debt is 2.89%, coming from the effective interest rate in 2019, where the average cost of capital is 6.42%. and the terminal bond is 5%. Free cash flow to the firm and terminal value are then discounted by WACC, resulting in the enterprise value equal to 4,481 baht. Finally, the price from discounted cash flow model is 35.8 baht. For price to earning PE multiple approach, we have picked 7 comparable peers where the criteria range from the asset size, the business location, and the nature of business. These 7 hospitals are used in our PE calculation. The average PE of 34.85 with 2019 earnings per share of 0.81 baht, resulting in the price of 28.29 baht. So, with 20% of this discounted cash flow approach, mixing with price to earning, 80% of price to earning multiples, we get the target price at 28 baht.
That's great. Our analysis, we use the Monte Carlo simulations to analyze the possibilities of the future price in the next 12 months. By simulating for 10,000 trials, the results suggest a 69.2% chance of obtaining the gain above the current price, would indicate a high probability of shareholder to earn more profit. For investment risk, our main concern of risk is the political instabilities, which have the moderate impacts and high probabilities. For political instabilities in Thailand is the key issue of the lessening the number of patients from foreign countries. To reduce such risk, the company is expanding the network of hospitals into other provinces across the country to reduce the risk of concentrations of number of patients in one particular area.
For the public component, we follow the Institute of Data Association criteria to calculate the CG scoring. The criteria consists line of shareholder, critical treatment of shareholder, no of stakeholder, disclosure and transparency, and more responsibility. The score on this category is then from 1 to 100. The score for finding is 87.3. And BDMS had the highest rating in the healthcare industry.
And to sum up, with a strong competitive positioning, supporting future trends, and robust financial performance, we strongly recommend you to buy BDMS at the target price of 28 baht with the upside of 18.64%. Thank you.
Question on the terminal growth, how did you come up with a 5% terminal growth? That's faster than
for the terminal growth, we found that the CAGR of the historical OPD is 6% and for IPD is 4%. And then we calculate for the weighted average between OPD and IPD number in private hospital. future, the people in Thailand will become aging society. So
yeah.
I think this can support.
And still have the benefit from the medical tourism. Does still have the highest growth that we will support? Maybe have the highest number of increasing for the number of protein and UD party.
Well, can find your validation method. You put the weight of 20% on the TCF, right, and 8% on the PE method. How does that come from? I mean, the way 20%, 8%, why it's not at a mixture?
Actually, we got the price of TCF at 25.8 and PE is 28.29. If the price is ranging between these two methods, I think it's okay. And we place an importance on the PE because it reflects more.
We thought it reflects the market.
BDMS deserves to trade at a lower multiple than Bumrungrad because they have poorer operations and corporate governance issues.
Yeah, we do think so, but also that BDMS is a bigger chain hospital. In the long run, we think that it would reflect more cost sharing.
Information on what the company tells them.
I we have actually we have more branches than they do, but also we I think we are in a way we are more innovative because BDM West has invested in preventive medication, whereas it's still a new trend.
And the largest number of the international patients come from which country?
Kuwait.
Kuwait. So apart from Thailand, where are they also going? They're not going to Australia, so I don't think so.
Singapore.
Okay.
But Singapore has a smaller size hospital.
How about China?
I'm not sure. I think also it is a kind of language barrier. I mean, BDMS also have the translator for like the Kuwait patient as well.
Actually, we also selected the hospital from Singapore, but the asset size is quite lower than the BDMS. Then we choose the similar asset size and nature of business. Also, our margin, our operating margin is above Lancashire Hospital and ESCO.
Do you have a breakdown of patients by nationality?
No. Sorry.
How do you think their wellness center business compares to Ponduli healthcare or other companies?
Or even like Bangkok, they just launched it yesterday.
Sorry, can you repeat the questions?
How do you think their wellness center business compares to Ponduli Healthcare, Bangkok, or any other company?
We think that the wellness center by BMS is super territories. They aim at a higher, they aim with a higher income patient. So that way, that will be their main focus, and also international patients.
Bangkok also, and they also, they're looking at Bangkok, I think. There are many more.
One of the technology that the BDMS used for the learning center will be one of the best entry in all the world. But when you compare to the BDMS, the Bangra, Bangra still have created the business in like kind of the learning center as well, but the technology that the Bangra used still have low in the lower level of the BDMS learning center.
The IRR of the wellness center in your assumption?
I'm sorry.
What's the IRR? You think that after they take over the student? Okay.
The presentation is complete. You can leave the room now. Please don't talk to any other teams about the judge patients for your benefits. We'll announce the four finalists in this evening. And we will send you just feedback and upload video clips of every team through our Facebook page after the final round.